This is Ben Weinman from the Dillinger Escape Plan at Rock on the Range. And we're here with Les Claypool from Primus, who just performed an amazing set. I saw 5 seconds of it. I ran over after we played.
But those 5 seconds were amazing, is that what you're saying?
Those 5 seconds were fantastic. How was the show for you?
You know, we don't play a lot of these big rock and roll things. And there was a lot of breastage flying around.
Breastage?
Yes, I was surprised. I hadn't, you know, haven't experienced that in
like
a while.
Like girls taking the breasticles out?
There was exposure of the mammary kind.
Wow. A girl did that at our show one time, and then she realized she was in the wrong show.
Yeah.
Are you guys working on new material?
We got a new record we just finished mixing.
Okay.
We're doing Goblin Rock. We're bringing Goblin Rock to the masses.
Popularizing Goblin Rock.
Goblin Rock, yes. It's the next new thing.
Exciting to me. Primus was a big band for me, an important band for me during my coming up and making music and making
Where did you grow up?
Things like that. In Jersey.
Jersey.
So I saw you guys
Lemoore's.
Lemoore's. I think I saw you. Did I see you?
Well, we used to always play Roseland, but that's no more.
Right.
Sad. That's sad.
I loved
Roseland. That was history.
You guys were considered pretty, like, a technical band. As a bass player, you were, like, the foremost, most amazing bass player. I'm saying from my point of view. I'm not asking you. I'm saying to us. You were like the guy on Bass Player magazine. It was like Flea and you. Most bass players did not get that kind of attention. Even though you were a front man, you were still like considered like just
a lot of it had to do with
technical bass player, and innovative.
I appreciate
player.
That, but a lot of it had to do with my actual physical beauty.
Yeah,
that really brought a lot of attention to the band.
I personally I didn't ever knew how handsome you were. I was just listening to the albums. We didn't have the internet back then.
Yes.
You know? So do you feel any kind of pressure now, like when you're writing new music? Oh wait, now I gotta be that bass guy again and like make all this crazy innovative bass stuff. You know what I mean? Because I would. I'm in a fairly technical band, and when I'm writing new music, I'm like, wait, am I doing enough of that stuff that they expect? You know what I mean? So
really,
do you ever feel that, or is it just like natural? You just make what you want to make.
I never really think of it that way. You know, I've said over and over again that the bass just happens to be the crayon I picked out of the box. You know, if I had played trumpet or accordion or whatever, I would be writing similar things because that's what's in my head, but that's the crayon I chose. Was the bass. With Primus, there's three guys, you know, and Larry's a very textural player. He's not like, you know, not like shoving his guitar in your face. So there's a lot of space to fill, you know. And then I got Tim Herb Alexander chasing me around, and I'm chasing him around. So there's lots of places to go.
But you didn't answer my question.
Oh, well, I thought I did. What was the...
Because you're writing the bass lines first.
I don't feel pressure at all.
So you don't even think about like
I think about
innovation.
The composition.
You're just like, I want to write a good song, and that's all I care about.
How can I make this goblin rock piece as goblin-y as I
can? I like that. I'm really glad to hear that.
Yeah, I don't really think about it.
I'm glad to hear that. That's great. And I'm sure it's going to be an amazing album. I'm looking forward to it. Well, thank you so much for taking the time to talk to me. Big fan. This is an amazing opportunity to be here playing with you guys and get the chance to talk to you and ask these questions. I've always had a lot of these questions and excited for the new music. The Goblin Rock coming soon to a theater near you.
Theater near you? I like it.